Hare Krishna. For changing yourself, focus on comprehending yourself, not on criticizing yourself. We all have probably had experiences of some teachers, guides, coaches who were always criticizing us. You didn't do that right, you didn't do that right. Now, their purpose might have been good. They may want us to change and improve. But they're constantly criticizing us, irritates us, exhausts us, disheartens us. And we just feel like getting away from them once and for all. Why should I be here? So similarly, if we learn to see that what will not work when somebody else does to us, why will it work if we do it to ourselves? We all have a desire to change ourselves, to become better human beings, to become better at various things in our life. But while seeking to change ourselves, what do? Sometimes we keep criticizing ourselves. Or rather, we can say our mind keeps discouraging and minimizing us, deriding us. Says you are good for nothing. What you have done is not going to be good enough. You are a fool. You are useless. Now, when we think like this, when we are disheartened like this, then what happens? We're just not able to do anything at all. So we when our mind is constantly criticizing us, we become disheartened. The same effect happens when we do it to ourselves or when somebody else does it to us. That's why the Bhagavad-Gita urges us to handle ourselves expertly. In 6.5, it states, Uddharedatmanatmanam, natmanam avasadayet, atmaiva ya atmano bandhur, atmaiva ripuratmanaha. He says, Uddharedatmanatmanam, elevate yourself with yourself. Natmanam avasadayet. Don't degrade yourself with yourself. Atmaivaya atmano bandhur. The self is the friend of the self. Atmaiva ripuratmanaha. The self is also the enemy of the self. This means that if we keep criticizing ourselves and that criticism discourages us, then we will become our own enemies. Then what do? So when somebody is constantly criticizing us, what do we seek? We want that the person should understand us. I'm trying. Please understand me, understand where I am at, and then help me. I also want to change. I also want to improve. But understand where I am and then give me a helping hand. So similarly, we can seek to comprehend ourselves. Now you may say, why do I know myself? No, we don't. No, we are very complicated beings in the sense that we all have multiple layers to our being. We are body, mind, soul, and in our mind there are various impressions. And beyond that, our soul has its pure spiritual longings, our body has its particular tendencies. So, we have to comprehend ourselves. That means we have to understand the kind of body-mind machine that we have, and understand its strengths, understand its weaknesses, understand where it is moldable, understand where it is not moldable, understand where we can presently use our energies in the most productive way. When we seek to understand ourselves in this way, then we will be able to channel our energy in a way that we will be able to make tangible transformations. And as we start making tangible transformations, improving ourselves, we will feel enlivened, we will feel encouraged, and then with that increased confidence, we can push forward, and thus we can spiral upward in a journey of self-improvement and self-actualization. Thank you. Hare Krishna.